Hey, it's Matt O'Leary, and this is the first album I think I've ever reviewed that could be classified as hardcore. It's the third record, Time and Space, from the Baltimore five-piece Turnstile. And coming in at just about 25 minutes in length, this one just demanded my attention every step of the way. I am such a sucker for melody, for jazzy chord changes, so the raw, gut-wrenching, pugilistic energy of this sound never really did it for me, and probably never will. But this album is the punk spirit embodied. It's the stage dive into chaos. It's a step outside the fortified and comfortable walled city of a genre label. The song Real Things is a no-nonsense track that really ensures us that these riffs are gonna be just straight to the point, no fat to trim. And it's one of the many tracks on the album, like Time and Space or like High Pressure, that are pretty standard fist pumpers. But just as you start to think that you're settling into a mood on this album, they cap off Real Things with this Wurlitzer electric piano section. And then just before you know it, maybe 10 seconds later, you fade back into the monotonous hardcore shouts of Big Smile. Like a jazzy thing. Did that just happen? All your purest hardcore bros are like, what was that? The band continues to confuse the sweaty moshers with stylistic left turns like the slacker R&B interlude Bomb. Kind of reminds me of that Homeshake album from last year. Or the inaccurately named track near the end called Disco, which was produced by Diplo, of all people. Disco by Diplo. Turnstile doesn't shy away from the pop melodies either, like on the slowest paced track, I Don't Want to Be Blind. Or the pop punk banger Moon with bassist Franz Lyons on the mic. At just under 2 minutes, that song is such a little sugar rush. His vocals have the richness or the clarity of like Brett Hines from Mastodon or Chris Cornell or something. And speaking of Soundgarden, there are plenty of late 80s and 90s sounds on this thing. Like the flanger guitar effects on Can't Get Away, just straight up Jane's Addiction. Or the riff on Right to Be, which is suspiciously similar to Nirvana's Breed. And yes, Rage Against the Machine, that one's pretty obvious. The lyrics are anything but callous or insensitive on Time and Space. There are some really vulnerable moments, like my favorite track, Generator. The emotions of a personal fallout cascade back and forth from the cold, bitter line, Don't Waste My Time, to the more desperate and more genuine and dramatic lines in the verses, like I'm hanging on, but I alienate, dancing with my pain now in the dark. Oof, that'll get ya. I love the Metallica riffs and that ripping guitar solo and the psychedelic middle section that links the whole thing together. It's glorious. The band's pretty much made up of drummers, so they incorporate a lot of percussive nuances, like the hyperspeed cowbells on Come Back for More, or those syncopated bass drum fills on the song Big Smile. Overall, this album is a big middle finger to anyone who wants a unidimensional hardcore sound and nothing else. There are plenty of momentary lapses in this macho man front that hardcore usually puts on. My only criticisms really are one, that some of the tracks feel a little bit underdeveloped, like there was some potential there that wasn't quite squeezed out. And also that a lot of the time when they transition into something lighter or jazzier, it feels a little bit abrupt. So I'm really hoping this is a stepping stone for the band, that next time they're able to take these eclectic styles and infuse them all together even better, like they did on the song Generator. I never heard of this band before, so this was definitely a fantastic surprise and an 8 out of 10 for me. Alright, let me know what you think of the album and the band Turnstile, and if you can, go over and check out, I just uploaded this morning an original song, it's called Steeple. I'm really proud of some of the lyrics in that, and as always, thank you so much for watching.